have some comedic horror coming up. First of all, leading off with something that is not funny. We've had a lot of news about AMC doing budget cuts. And of course, a lot of the streaming services have run into the fact that streaming has... It has its place, but the growth in streaming platforms has significantly slowed because there's only so many eyes on the planet and there's only so many hours in the day. This is something that should have been fairly obvious, but a lot of these folks had really ambitious streaming growth plans that just have not seemed to borne out the way that they were hoping for, which is welcome to the wonderful world of business. That happens sometimes. So there's been Shudder, of course, is the very, very popular with horror fans streaming service. It's actually one of my favorite streaming services because there's a lot of great horror content on there. A lot of great classic horrors as well as new productions. Well, they've seen their share of layoffs and it's hitting them fairly hard in some of the folks who've been there for quite some time. And this is the nature, unfortunately, of business. Layoffs will happen. And there's been a lot of reporting on it, a lot of questionable reporting on it. And in all fairness here, I'm using this particular image from We Got This Covered. Now, We Got This Covered has had criticisms, and however you feel about that site or the criticisms, this is an example of what we've seen that's been popping up, unfortunately, where, if you can't read it, horror fans fear for the future as Shudder gets axed by AMC. Okay, this is a headline, and this is not what's happening. Shudder is not being axed by AMC. Staff members at Shudder and staff members at AMC are losing their jobs. In fairness to We Got This Covered, they corrected the headline when it was pointed out that Shudder is not shutting down. So... Just almost a PSA here, folks. Read beyond the headline. The article itself that's attached to this is much more accurate than that headline is in terms of describing the situation. But we're an instant consumer society, and read beyond the headlines. Get into the meat of the article, and then you know, don't just accept it all as what's right there, because they are not the only ones who have been doing this. And of course, as this news comes quickly, we're going to see more of this sort of stuff. We've seen it obviously with other services as well. But unfortunately is the nature of the business. But again, goodness, folks, read beyond the headline and get the headlines right in the first place. And we're the kind of company organization that we tend to write our own headlines. And that's not always the case for other, a lot of larger news services run into this problem all the time. We're going to be watching Shudder very closely because, like I said, quite frankly, it's one of my favorite streaming services and it's a great location for horror. If you want to support them, I would encourage it, but do what's best for you. Oh my. And we are coming into the Oscar nomination season, and the folks over at Universal Pictures have put out a For Your Consideration trailer for Jordan Peele's Nope for any or all eligible categories. Now, of course, Jordan Peele won an Oscar for Get Out, Best Original Screenplay, nominated for Best Picture, Best Performance by an Actor in a Leading Role, and Best Achievement in Directing. So certainly there are places that Nope could be nominated, and as someone who, it's not my favorite of Peele's movie, but I enjoyed it, there's some stuff that could definitely be up for nomination, but expect to see a lot more of this. And the great part is that we're seeing more genre films fall into this, and maybe we'll see some more genre films actually win. Wouldn't that be nice? Currently winning at the box office, at least especially against their own budget, is Violent Night, that David Harbour as Santa Claus, Santa Claus meets Die Hard, is a fairly accurate description from a lot of people right now. And it's doing pretty well over the course of its opening weekend. So the opening weekend and preview, it has so far pulled in $20 million worldwide, which considering that its budget was $20 million, not too shabby. Of course, they hope this is going to continue. Your production budget is not just the money that you are looking to make up, you also have to worry about your advertising budget. Now, Violent Night did not get a gigantic advertising push, so they might be in pretty solid position here to do very, very well in terms of turning a profit. And the reviews have all been pretty solid as being a kind of fun holiday horror slash diehard experience. So congratulations to them, not doing too shabby there. And we got news, of course, that we're getting, well, we've known we're getting a Ghostbusters Afterlife sequel. Now we know that the director is going to be Gil Kenan, and he is the first film's writer and executive producer. And Jason Reitman is stepping back, is going to be moving to writer-producer role, and with Kenan and Jason Blumfeld as the writers for the next one. But Kenan's going to be taking the directorial reins. The film is going to move back to New York City. We're going to go back to the classic firehouse. And that's about what we know at this point. December 2023 is the expected release window. And looks like production is going to go starting here in January. So we'll obviously have more news as this moves along. And we talked about the BruceFest 2022 not too long ago. We showed a picture that was released last week from Evil Dead Rise. And we have another one here. But we also have a little description of the trailer, which was shown at BruceFest. Has not been released to the general public yet, but it leans into some dark humor and a lot of splatter, as one would expect. The premise here is, and I quote, a road-weary Beth pays an overdue visit to her older sister, Ellie, who's raising three kids on her own in a cramped LA apartment. The sisters' reunion is cut short by the discovery of a mysterious book deep in the bowels of Ellie's building, giving rise to flesh-possessing demons and thrusting Beth into the primal battle for survival as she is faced with the most nightmarish version of motherhood imaginable. So that's going to be cheerful. This is very much leaning into, again, the darker aspects, not the humorous aspects of the Raimi ones. But there is definitely still some humor here. Lines like, it was the most beautiful day, it was a perfect day. All I could think about was how much I wanted to cut you open and climb inside your bodies, depending on how that's delivered, or a child sitting there opening the door or looking through the peephole at her mother, who is apparently possessed by a deadite, and going, you don't look so good, Ma. So, yeah, but there's, the trailer shows the Necronomicon, and there's lots of deadites, and we are still looking at April 21st. For the release date, and apparently there is going to be a chainsaw and someone is going to pick it up. So things to look forward to there. Okay, now we have got, I'm just going to jump to it. We've had Pooh, we've had the Grinch. Now it's time for Heidi. That's right. The little girl from Switzerland and the Pigtails. Casper Van Dien is playing the evil villain, the new president of Switzerland, who has malicious plans for the country's cheese. The trailer is out. You can actually get the film from the website. These are... it is available now. You can rent it for $9.90. And it is a glorious, ridiculous trailer. Lots of heads exploding and inappropriate ways to use cheese to do damage to other people. It is cheerfully tongue in cheek, but I was not expecting to go to Heidi just yet, but here's where we are. And Velocipastor 2 is on its way. If you're not familiar with the Velocipastor film, the first one, the premise is that a priest inherits an unusual ability to turn into a dinosaur. He then uses it to fight evil. Well, Velocipastor 2 is on its way. This time they're heading to the city of Rome. And it is described as production team says, this is not just Velocipastor again, it's more. We want this film to be our Evil Dead 2 to our Evil Dead. If you're a newcomer who only maybe saw the memes, that's totally fine. This will also be a great jumping in point while still making sure we have all the right winks for you hardcore fans. I don't think we have a date for this yet, but I'm sure we'll have more information as time goes by. And in the remake, or potential remake, I'm not sure about this. Apparently, there's discussions happening where Alfred Hitchcock's The Birds is going to be remade, and Scarlett Johansson is in discussions to play the lead. And this was originally played by Tippi Hedren back in 1963. And of course, there are many stories about her abuse at the hands of Alfred Hitchcock, some of it quite violent, involving live birds. Not very cool, but it is also an example of Hitchcock's skill as a director. I'm sorry, in terms of producing the film, not as dealing with his cast, because clearly not. But this is not the first rumored remake of The Birds. Back in 2014, Naomi Watts was part of a rumor of a new version of The Birds being made. So we'll have to wait and see. I'm going to be a little bit skeptical. The only reporting we've seen so far is a trusted and proven source that was provided to a giant freaking robot. And so we'll see what happens. I'm not much of a believer in the rumor mill for pretty much anything that comes out with trusted sources without actual backing it up. But we'll see what happens. We'll see what happens. What is definitely coming to screens is a remake of Unhinged, one of the original 72 video nasties, the films that ended up on the UK's list of movies that were not going to be allowed to be shown in their country. A lot of that stuff, of course, is widely available now, and in many cases is not particularly shocking and wouldn't have necessarily been shocking at the time, but for whatever reasons, they ended up on that list. Came out in 1982, during a period where a lot of slasher horror films were exploding onto the scene. Proportion Productions and Champ Dog Films are doing the remake. Scott Jeffrey from Winnie the Pooh, Blood and Honey, is going to produce the new take. And Ellis Starbuck from Crocodile Vengeance, Betsy Blue English from Sky Kraken, Sian Altman of Curse of Humpty Dumpty, Toby Wynn Davies from Area 51 Incident, and Chloe Carr are the stars of this. The original film involved three college students, Nancy, Terry, and Gloria. They were on their way to a rock concert. They were driving through a rainstorm. There was a crash. They take shelter and discover a man-hating mother and her daughter, and it does not go well for our trio of college students. We'll have to see what the modern version does with it. And the microbudget film Skinamarink, I haven't seen the film, so I'm not sure how that's pronounced, has gotten a lot of really great reviews. Of microbudget films, of course, being very much below the standard $5 million, $10 million, whatever you're getting for a lot of lower budget horror films. Looking at sometimes in the thousands of dollars and tens of thousands of dollars. It's gotten a ton of buzz. It's debuted at Fantasia International Film Festival. Shudder picked it up for distribution. It's going to get a theatrical run in January. And then it's going to be coming up on Shudder in 2023. Well, this is really, really fantastic news for a small indie feature. Now, excuse me, pardon me. The premise here, if you haven't seen anything about it, is two children wake up in the middle of the night to discover their father is missing and the windows and the doors of their home have vanished entirely. They bring pillows and blankets into the living room and just try and deal with the situation as best they can, playing videotapes, watching cartoons. And of course, they're not alone. So definitely something to check out if you are interested in such things. And we talked earlier, last week or the week before, I can't remember which one, that Doug Bradley is returning to the horror sphere in the new film Thorns. Well, the trailer is out, and it has certainly some visual connections to the Hellraiser universe, at least in terms of the production design, but it also looks a lot like a kind of a low budget 1980s thriller in many ways. Pretty mixture of practical and digital effects, and it seems to very much have a religious theme. There is an observatory that has gone silent, and an investigator makes his way to it. Doug Bradley is his advisor, who he talks to over a video call. And this ex-priest who is working for NASA goes to investigate and discovers that there's something that they a signal that has come through that has origins, perhaps, in a more hellish place. Looking sometimes in 2023 for the release date, but the trailer's out now. You can check that out. We don't have a trailer yet. We do have an image for The Black Demon, which is apparently based on a Mexican legend. Rambo Last Blood director. I don't know why that was hard to say. Adrian Grunberg is the director on this. It's going to come out in 2023 and April 21st, and it's going to come out on demand May 22nd. The premise here involves a family going to Bahia Negra, is the crown jewel of Baja, the Mexican coastal town, and for an oil job. And a giant black shark begins to terrorize pretty much everyone. So, giant shark films have their own place in the horror pantheon, and so certainly something to check out there. And we already talked about Knock at the Cabin and its trailer and the premise on previous shows, but we now have a rating for the new M. Night Shyamalan film. It is going to be rated R, which is unusual, actually, for his films. Most of his films have been rated PG-13. The last film that he had that was actually the only other film that he's had that was rated R was The Happening. So certainly, I'm not sure what that means in terms of what to expect for Knock at the Cabin, but I'm sure we'll find out. And the trailer for the first trailer for Megan inspired a lot of people doing the little Megan dance that she does in that trailer. Now your second trailer has dropped, which gives a little more information about the story, and very much anyone thinking that this might be a female doll version of evil male doll version Chucky could be forgiven for seeing the similarities. There's a lot here to compare, but also not quite the jokey tone, although the trailer does have some humor. It's very much looking like, I don't know. I mean, the trailers look good. We'll have to see. Of course, this is coming from Jason Blum and James Wan, so they definitely have the experience, but the new trailer does give you a little more information about the film. And there we go. Sorry about that. We've heard that Tobin Bell is coming back for Saw 10. Now there's apparently talk that Shawnee Smith is interested in returning to play her role in the franchise. Amanda Young was the name of the character she played back in the original 2004. First Saw film, 2004. It's been a while. Then, of course, she was revealed, spoiler alert for films that are quite old at this point, she was revealed to be an accomplice, and now she's potentially going to return, although she, like John Kramer, in context of the film universe, should be dead. Flashbacks, maybe. And Slumber Party Massacre and Slumber Party Massacre 2 are finally making their way to Ultra HD and Blu-ray, coming out February 21st of next year. Now, the out-of-print Blu-ray sets have been available, but they're very, very pricey at this point. So the fact that we're actually getting a new set, if you're a fan of these films, is definitely something to pick up. The really the price jump for all picking up the older versions has been kind of shockingly steep. So this is looking at, don't have a price listed yet, but it's going to come out, you know, very, very soon. So I'm sure we'll have more information about that. Now, this is a 3-disc set. So the two films and a bunch of extras. We've also got The Return of Swamp Thing, the second of the Swamp Thing feature films, getting its 4K Ultra HD coming up from Lightyear Entertainment. This was actually a bit interesting because it's coming out before the first film, the Wes Craven directed Swamp Thing, has come out on 4K Ultra HD, but okay. It's been newly restored, and we're looking at, it's in the works here. I don't believe it is out yet, but it's certainly going to be something to watch for on the way. And coming off of BruceFest, we also had the announcement that the Bubba Hotep 4K Ultra HD is coming out, 20th anniversary of Bubba Hotep, Scream Factory putting this one out, a vivid new 4K master, and February 7th, lots of extras. It's available for pre-order now. And Stephen King's The Gunslinger is heading to television as a series. Mike Flanagan, the guy behind The Haunting of Hill House and Midnight Mass, has put together a deal, acquired the rights, and is going to be adapting Stephen King's The Dark Tower into a TV series. Now, he had this interview with Deadline. Now, of course, we reported last week that he is actually moving from Netflix to Amazon. This is not included in that deal. This is a separate thing entirely. So it could end up at Amazon. It could end up at Netflix. Wherever it's going to end up is still to be determined at this point. But that happened before that deal was with Amazon, so it's not included in it. Now, Amazon did have the rights to The Dark Tower at one point to produce, and of course, they no longer did. And Flanagan has talked to Stephen King and has given him his outline and has gotten approval. So we'll have to see if this is a thing that actually happens. This is not the first time, like I said, not the first time we tried to get see The Gunslinger or The Dark Tower series come to television. And of course, we had the feature film, which a lot of people would just like to forget ever happened. Sorry, guys. And we have some photos being revealed. Excuse me. Someone in my throat today. From the new Daryl Dixon show, The Walking Dead spinoff. And that's, we know the production is underway. And as Daryl heads off to France, Daryl's European vacation, and discovers that part of the mystery of the show is that he doesn't know how he got there. He doesn't speak the language. So it's a brand new environment and a lot of confusion. And we'll have to see how this plays out. And of course, this was originally planned that it would be Daryl and Carol from The Walking Dead. And that is currently not the case, but with talk that Melissa McBride may join him later. No particular certainty about that at this point. And while The Boys is certainly a darker take on the superhero genre, and both in the comic book and in the TV adaptation, Gen V seems to be leaning a lot more into the horror side of things based on the new trailer. We'll have to see how much that actually develops in terms of when the show comes out. But the trailer is out. You get to see the brand new cast, and you get to see lots of blood and people being seriously damaged, and strange puppets that seem to have internal organs, and all kinds of just the craziness you would expect to see from The Boys, anything in The Boys universe. But yeah, very much leaning into the horror aspects here. So that's your thing. Definitely check that out. And riding on the success, or continuing from the success, I guess they're separate things, of the Interview with the Vampire series that AMC is currently running. The Mayfair Witches full trailer has dropped and is an adaptation of the Anne Rice novels, just like Interview with the Vampire is. It's going to come out on January 8th on AMC and AMC Plus, and definitely looks very lush. Of course, the premise here is that Rowan, who is the lead character, the Rowan is a young neurosurgeon who discovers that she is descended from a bloodline of witches, and how this basically upends her life. And it certainly has some connections to the interview, to the Vampire Chronicles. So we'll have to see if this crosses over at any point. But definitely, if they continue to have the quality of production. I have not seen the new Interview with the Vampire series, but a lot of reviews have been praised it very, very highly for being a good, solid adaptation. So we'll have to see what happens. And on the gaming side of things, we have a release date for Diablo 4. And it's going to be June 6th, 2023. Now, this has long been delayed and long rumored, and we finally have a release date. So that's very good news for fans of the game. This was released after a Twitter user discovered a hidden listing on the Microsoft Store that apparently revealed the release date. Well, it turned out to be true, so they went ahead and made the announcement over there at Blizzard. It's going to come in three separate editions for PC and console, Standard, Digital Deluxe, and Ultimate. Pre-ordering the game is available now. It can give you early access to the open beta, and then it's going to come to PC, PlayStation 4, PlayStation 5, Xbox One, and the Xbox Series. So if you're a fan of that series, I'm sure you're very excited. And Hellboy is coming back to video games. I think there's one game before, but I'm not sure. But anyway, Hellboy Web of Weird is a third-person roguelite action adventure. And of course, Mike Mignola and Dark Horse Comics helped contribute to the story. It sends Hellboy on a series of vastly different and wholly unique adventures that are all tied to the mysterious Butterfly House. We don't have a release date for this yet, but we'll definitely have news as that develops. And developer In Dreams has put out a new trailer for Ghostbusters Rise of the Ghost Lord. You can see what it's like to play with a PKE meter, boss ghosts with the proton wand, use traps, a whole new cast of new ghosts, all serving the Ghost Lord, and it's a virtual reality game. You start in the Ghostbusters HQ, the new one, in San Francisco, and gear up, and all the fun stuff that follows from that. It's going to come out sometime in 2023 for MetaQuest 2, excuse me, and PlayStation VR 2. And you can sign up for the wish list through the Meta Store if that's something you're looking forward to. And finally, The Last of Us Part 1 is coming to PC. The fact that it hasn't been available for PC is something a lot of people who don't particularly want to buy consoles have been asking for a very long time. March 3rd, 2023, the remake of the game, the original game, is going to come to Steam and Epic Games. So you can definitely pick that up, not too, while you're waiting for the new series to drop. And if you are a fan of Do the Thing, I think I need to replace. Whoa! The buttons on my mouse, I think, needs to be happening here, or the batteries in my mouse. Okay, so Killer Clowns from Outer Space, the game, is out, is coming next year. They've been releasing new images and some of the new character designs. This is one of the new characters from the game called the Lackeys. You can see a first look promo video out. It's a 3x7 asymmetrical multiplayer horror game, of course, based on the movie. And I'm sure we'll have a lot more information as that develops as well. That is all the news I have for you guys today. Thank you for joining us here on Sci-Fi for Me and for our weekend update. And we hope that you have a wonderful December and a wonderful rest of your week.
And we do have more Swamp Thing news, because we have more Swamp Thing news. And it's February. Excellent. February 7th is when the return of Swamp Thing is hitting the shelves.
Oh, thank you.
So that is out there.
Good Morning Multiverse, Saturday morning at 11, 10 Central, only on Sci-Fi for Me TV.